during this particular point of time, we should prepare for which exam? For prelims or mains? Definitely the answer. Hello everyone, welcome to Plutus IAS. Myself Vivek Raj. In this particular video lecture, I will talk about this particular topic, that is how to effectively prepare for UPSC CSE 2025. As we know that all those people who haven't made to the mains this year, they're not qualified for the mains this year, they will be preparing for next year, right? Or otherwise also all those people who are targeting the 2025 UPSC examination. So basically for them, you know, we have the prelims examination. So when we have the prelims examination next year, that is May 25th, we have the prelims. And when we have the mains examination, so we have approximately it is 20th August, right? 2025. So this is the timeline. So considering this, you know, prelims is on 25th May 2025 and this mains is on 28th August, like it will be starting around this date. So how much time exactly we have? We have, you know, approximately you can say June, July, that is 60, and 20 days these, that's 80, 85 days are there, right? But we are very well aware of that when you will be coming out of examination after appearing for prelims examination, then the speculation will be starting that you will be counting your marks, you will be, you know, hoping for your result. And majority of the people, majority I mean to say 80-90% will not be able to study and they will be focusing on only the result, that whether I'll be in the list or I'll be out of the list. So what I want to say is that during that time till your prelims result will not be there, you will not be able to study. This is the fact and that we have seen. Okay, so out of these 80 to 85 days that UPSC has given to us between prelims and mains, I am saying effectively you will be reading or you will have time to study only 60 days. What does it mean? In the prelims 2025 and the mains 2025, in between that period, we have only 60 days effectively when you will be having, you know, prelims result will be there and you will be studying. And also like just before 10 days before the mains examination or 1 week before the mains examination, it will not be possible for you to study properly. That's why I'm, you know, separating these 60 days. So effectively it is 60 days that you will have after your prelims. Okay. So actually I want that we should take this thing very seriously. And this is practical also, that how exactly we will be preparing for mains examination, that is 2025 mains, right? So I'll be removing this now. We have 60 days between the prelims and the mains next year. So considering that, as of now, we are in the month of July, okay? And, you know, if we are in July and your prelims is in the month of May, then during this particular point of time, we should prepare for which exam? For prelims or mains? Definitely, the answer will be and it should be the mains examination. Because we have only 60 days to prepare for the mains examination after prelims. And also, you cannot prepare for the mains examination 2, 3 or 4 months before the prelims examination. It will be little difficult, right? Especially for those people who haven't appeared for or who haven't qualified prelims earlier. So, we can say January onwards, you will be focusing on the prelims. So can we say that this July to December time period is available for or is very suitable time to prepare for the mains. So based on this, I'll say that July to December 2024, I am talking about, should be specifically given to the mains preparation. Is our agenda is, focus area is plan for 1 year. So I'm giving you the plan for 1 year, July to December. You should specifically prepare for the mains examination. It will be helping you definitely to prepare for the mains 2025, and also it will be helping you in clearing the prelims 2025, because when you will be having the deep analysis or thorough reading of the topics of mains examination, definitely it will be helping you in the prelims also, right? Then we will have the January to May, or we can say this is May, or we can say till prelims, you will be focusing on the prelims. In general, I am talking about that January to May till prelims, you will be preparing for prelims. But some people used to, cover some topics of mains examination till January in Feb also. But in general, I'm talking about this is the time period. This is the most, suitable or general kind of time period that should be preferred. Then again, in June to August, that is, till mains, you should prepare for definitely the mains examination, because you will have only 60 days, right? So this is the time period. We should take this thing very seriously. Why I am highlighting on this? Because from January onwards, automatically you will be studying, no doubt about that, because prelims will be there. And if you will be clearing prelims, definitely you will be studying very hard during this period, that is June to August, no doubt about that. But this period is very, very important also, because we will have so many festivals and, weather changes will be there. So I have generally observed that students used to miss these months, right? So it becomes a problem, because when you will not be covering the syllabus substantially in this particular period, then it becomes difficult during the, just before the exam, like be it prelims or the mains examination. So I'll recommend that you cover the things in this period. It will be really helpful for you. Okay. So this is about 1 year plan that one should follow. Okay. Now we will talk about how to balance GS and optional. So when I mentioned that we should give this time period to the prelims, mains and integrated preparation. Now we have how to balance GS and the optional. So during this time, that is July to December, we should definitely prepare for the optionals as well, because of the same reason that we don't have much time between the prelims and the mains examination, right? So as of now, I'll suggest that 4 hours to GS, 4 hours to GS, and then 4 hours to your optional, it should be, the time period that you should give, right? And for sure, like starting from July, August, September, October, or maximum by November, you have 3, 4, 5 months, you complete your optional completely, cover your optional completely, and you should make notes, you should refer to the PYQs, and same is the case with the GS, right? So it is very important. And then, if you will be having your notes and all the syllabus complete by December, it will be really great achievement for you. Only you have to prepare, for prelims specifically and then mains specifically, and your work is done, right? So this is one. So this is also very clear now. that we have to balance, we have to give equal time to GS and optional during this time. Now we have the notes making and answer writing. As I mentioned, that you will be giving 4 hours each as of now from July to December to optional in the GS. It is equally important that you are doing the answer writing and you are making proper notes, right? So short notes should be made. Too lengthy notes are not welcomed. You should make those kind of notes which you are helping, the notes are helping in revising before, just before the examination. It is very, very important. Okay, so whatever you are reading, any material you are referring, you should make notes out of that. Short notes are desirable so that you, it will be helping. And then when you are covering a particular topic, you should do the answer writing with the help of, you know, joining some program, or at least, you know, you can attempt questions that have been asked in the previous year. So it is very, very important that you are doing all this also. Okay. And then the last thing that I will talk about is the integration of current affairs. So this is the time period when the exam is not in front of you. You have little window to, you know, improve upon the things. So here what you will do is that whatever topic you are covering, you will be integrating those topics with that of the current affairs. Everything which will be going on around that you will be noting down, it will be really helping you in, you know, building your concept, in bringing about clarity in your, you know, preparation and your ideas, right? So it is highly recommended that along with the optional and the GS that you are covering, you are reading the newspaper on daily basis. And also I will recommend that along with the newspaper, you should refer to a monthly magazine also, because in most of the cases I have seen that it becomes difficult for the students to cover the newspaper completely. So it's no problem with that. You read some of the articles on daily basis from the newspaper and then you cover rest of the things from the magazine. So this is all about how to effectively prepare for UPSC CSE. So broadly what we discussed is that July to December you will be covering the mains examination along with the notes, along with the answer writing, and then January to May it is prelims, then again mains, because we have very less time. So I hope this will be helping you in preparing for UPSC CSE 2025 in a better way. So this is all. Thank you.